lot of effort into it. Do we have any joys, concerns, or announcements?
Jesse's very, very, very sick.
Is Jesse still very sick? What happened?
I think she must have had a relapse. She sounded absolutely awful, off every breath.
Man, I spoke to Miss Gary this past week. He and Gail have also been pretty sick. They think they've been passing it. Back and forth, one get well, and then sick again, and then just bounce back and forth between each other. So he was asking for.
Jesse don't think she's contagious because she said her grandson, granddaughter, none of them would call it.
Well, don't tell Miss Jesse I said it, but maybe it's just me that's coming out. What they always tell me when I was sick, it's just me that's coming out. But I didn't believe it. Any others?
Well, I've got a joy. Thanks to the help of my brother, I finally got all of my water pipes fixed that froze on me.
All right. That's a blessing right there for sure.
I went with that well ever since I got back from Tennessee. I think the old day before yesterday without water.
Tough to do. Especially in the wintertime.
She had water in the commode.
I had water running, cold water in the bathtub. That was it.
Well, he was like bathing in the creek then, wouldn't he? Tough in the wintertime. Why, them old cowboy days, they only took a bath like once every time they went to town, maybe once a month or so. If that. Any others?
Maybe some last week, great for us to go home. Sherry Ayler today, grandbaby.
I heard that. She got to go home, and they said, I heard that once they got all the medical stuff away from her and they let the wind come in, that it was just like a complete 180 turnaround. And awesome. Any others? Boys, concerns, announcements? Unspoken? We've got, announcement-wise, we've got a game night on the 27th, which is a Friday at 6 o'clock. So spread the word around. We're going to come and enjoy some fellowship, and probably some refreshments, some games. I don't know what kind of games. I don't have any idea. But I know it's going to be fun. I know we're going to get together and enjoy one another's company. And just have a good time, right?
Mr. Colleen on there for surgery Wednesday.
Miss Colleen's coming up. She's got surgery procedure Wednesday. Lift her up like she's kind of nervous about it. I think Miss Dixon's been giving her all the gory details, and I don't think she's really enjoying that right now. She's not enjoying all that, so usually you're kind of stressed about surgery anyway, and then when people start telling you what they're going to do, it makes it even just bumps it up even more. So, also, we'll lift Miss Nikki up as Miss Colleen is recovering. To be nice to her. we've got, I know announcement wise, we've got Good Sunday coming up. We're going to have, I guess we're going to be lunch that day, probably potluck that day. I know we've got our community Good Sunday singing. I haven't heard of where that's going to be at, but on that Sunday, instead of me getting before you and boring you with another message, I thought it'd be cool to do something different. And so really I'm telling you now so you can prepare. But come that Sunday prepared to share a story or something that God has done miraculous in your life that we can just enjoy and praise Him for. Amen. I don't think we do that enough. I think we pray for one another enough, and we sometimes hear of where God is working, but I don't think we share enough amongst ourselves of what God is doing. It can be present, it can be past, it can be any part of your life where God has done something great that you just can't hold it in, and that you want to share it with. We'll come in, we'll do our songs and stuff. And then we'll go into that instead of me speaking to you today, because I think that will be a good time for us to fellowship and just learn something about what God has done in our lives. I know God has done lots of stuff in my life that I can tell you about. So I know that anybody here God has done anything in your life. Yeah, you've got done something in your life? Oh yeah. So I think we can all probably come up with something to share. And I know people are gonna say, oh, I don't talk to some people. We talk to some people every Sunday. We talk to one another every Sunday. All right? It's not like you're getting up, giving an address to, you know, 10,000 people. It's us. It's family, y'all. Right? Amen. So I think that'd be cool. So y'all be thinking about it. Let us know something that God has done in your life. Any others? We got to say, if y'all haven't been to a little Dribblers game, y'all are missing out, because that is some fun and exciting right there. Especially when they're about this high. And the ball is just about bigger than they are. And they're trying to show them how to dribble, and they pick it up and run more steps, and then they bounce it and pick it up and run more steps.
It's the NBA.
So the games are here in Douglas this week. Usually start around 8-ish. Any others? Most of you have two games left? Then what am I going to do with my Saturday? Softball? Baseball, softball?
Back
here.
The
sign-up
sheet, the scores,
we'll have to
send that out, and
then
we'll sign up
and we'll
name the church
name each time we choose to have a picture of all that's back there on the table, take a gander at it. See if there's a spot
for leaving the field. Help out. And we have three seniors this year that we are doing a party for, so if you want to help with that, let me and Mr. Lee know.
Okay. Graduate kindergarten, it's all downhill from there, folks. Any others? Anybody else? Joys, concerns, and help? Anybody? Let's throw our Lord in prayer. Gracious, wonderful God, we do again thank you so much for this amazing day that you've blessed us with. And we thank you, dear God, for the joy that we got to hear this morning. And answer prayers, dear Lord. We know that you're always working, dear God. Sometimes it's on our timeline, sometimes it's not, dear Lord. But we know that your hand is always upon us, dear Lord, and that you are always good to us, dear God. And that every day there is reason to praise you, dear God. We ask that you would help us to see those reasons, dear Lord, even more, so that we may praise you even more, dear God, so that others may know of your greatness, dear God, and we will thank you for it, dear Lord. We thank you for the opportunity to lift those names and situations that have been called this morning for various reasons, even those ones that are unspoken, dear God, still in our hearts and minds as well. We ask that you would reach them into those lives, dear God, and bring healing and peace and comfort and strength in areas needed, dear God. Father, we thank you that we were able to gather. We thank you that we have gathered as a family, dear Lord, as a body of Christ. We ask that you continue to send us forward, dear Lord, that if we are to be your strength and peace into this world and courage, that you put us into the paths of people that we need to be, dear God, that we may just speak a word of encouragement, dear Lord, or be that shoulder to cry on, or that that ear to listen, dear God. And Father, we thank you for this active blessing upon us as we move forward, dear God. We do ask that as a nation you continue to bless us, dear Lord, and we also ask that you would humble us, dear God, that you would help us to climb down off of our high horse, dear Lord, see that we need you, dear God, and may you help us to see you because of that, dear Lord. We can prepare the name of you. Amen. Everybody report? Every time I try, I stay from a tune. In all those lonely roads that I travel, baby, Jesus. When the life I feel a pain crashing to the ground. When the friends I have nowhere to be. I couldn't see anything that I can see. But there was Jesus. In the way, in the searching, in the years. Let us give thanks. Father God, we do thank you again for this day. We thank you, dear Lord, for the many wonderful blessings that you have given to us. We're so thankful for the opportunity, dear God, to give us back to you, dear Lord. We do pray that you have moved us, dear God, that we have given as freely and joyfully that we have been given to you, dear Lord. And we just ask that you take these gifts and bless these gifts, dear Lord. Multiply these gifts for you to do so. We say we pray in the name of Jesus. Well, as our young ones are exiting, let us turn to the book of 1 Peter, chapter 1, and we're going to read verses 3 through 5. 3 and 5. 1 Peter, chapter 1. Page 738 in my Bible. I don't know if that helps anybody out. But. No. Okay.
1 Peter,
chapter 1. Start with verse 3. And if you are able, please rise. Please stand for the reading of God's word. First Peter chapter 1, starting with verse 3. I love the way that starts out.
All praise.
All praise. That's good. All to start off with praise. Amen. All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is by His great mercy that we have been born again, because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. Now we live with a great expectation, and we have a priceless inheritance, an inheritance that is kept in heaven for you, pure and undefiled, beyond the reach of change and decay. And through your faith, God is protecting you by His power until you receive this salvation, which is ready to be revealed on the last day for all to see. Amen. This is God's word for God's people. May He add His blessing to the reading, the hearing, and the understanding of it. You may be seated. Father God, once again, we thank you for this blessed day that you have given us, and we thank you for your word. We thank you that we were able to read your word, dear God. But we ask that it doesn't stop with just reading, that you also open our hearts and our minds that we might receive your word. We just pray that through the power of the Holy Spirit, the words that I speak today, they would not be my own, dear God, but they would be the words that you would have us read. And we do ask that you strengthen us as we hear and see these things we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Well, it's getting into January pretty good, and I know that, maybe some folks have already been doing it, but I know this is the time of year where people kind of start making plans for the summer. They start planning their summer vacation or their family trips, and I'll thinking about this week, and you know how much better you feel when you start playing with your family? Now, I'm not traveling. I don't lie. I like to just stay at home. You know, I don't really care for going places, but taking the family vacation with the family during the summer, you know, it just puts a little bit of spring in the step. You know what I mean? Because it's something that we do that's out of the ordinary. We get out of our normal routine, you know what I mean? Because the normal everyday life will chew us up and spit us out if we're not careful. Amen? You get in that everyday grind of getting up at a certain time, and you go to work, and you do this, and then you come home, and you got your high school, and you got kids to raise, you got supper to cook, and laundry to do, and homework to work on. And all of those things are just day in and day out, and day in and day out. And it gets to the point where we just get bogged down in it, don't we? We just get overrun by that, and it just feels like it's just the same old thing each and every day, which it usually is, but that's what makes vacation so great. That's what makes taking a trip so great, because we move out of that everyday anymore, right? We get out of that everyday rut of life, and we get to do something different. We don't normally have to clean every day, or we don't have to, prepare this or prepare that. It's just kind of, we just get to do something fun, and it puts a little bit of a pep in our step, I was thinking about it this week, and I was thinking about Paul telling us to rejoice always. Rejoice in the Lord always. I mean, Philippians 4:4, he tells us to rejoice in the Lord always. He says, I'll even say it again, rejoice in the Lord. And I know that it's easy for us to look at Paul and go, well, yeah, of course Paul can rejoice. You see, he didn't go through the things that I'm going through. He doesn't have the same old rut of life that I'm in. I mean, Paul is associated with greatness when it comes to biblical terms. You know what I mean? Paul did a whole lot of stuff for Jesus, and his faith was this big, and mine's only like this, But what most folks don't understand is that Paul was also a man who had trouble. Paul was also a person who everyday life beat him up pretty bad because he was in prison. Amen? And he was stoned. He was beaten, and he was flogged, and he was shipwrecked. And he knew what hunger was. He knew what it was to be in danger. He knew what it was to be on the run. He knew what it was to be in need, and yet he was still able to say, amen, praise the Lord always. Anybody going through something, struggling? I got any health concerns, or maybe some financial concerns, or some relationship concerns? You can be with a spouse or a family member, or maybe just a friend. Anybody got something going on in our life? Is anybody tired of going to work every single day and doing the same old thing every single day? Has everyday life got you in a rut and just beat you down and beat you up? And you're just wondering, when is it all in?
You used to be there?
I get there quite often, to be honest with you. Because, life is difficult. And that's why I think sometimes that I think about heaven a lot. I've already got a trip planned. If you believe in Jesus Christ, you already got a trip planned too. It's going to be an awesome trip. And we can praise God, amen, for that. Because it's through Jesus Christ that we have that trip there. It's through Jesus Christ that we have that great expectation. Now, I have pretty good expectations of every day. But it is a great expectation. Amen. Come on now. It is a great expectation when you sit and think about heaven, because that is our inheritance. Jesus died. When we believe in him, we become his brothers and sisters. We become children of God. And he died so that we might have that inheritance, that heavenly inheritance that does not spoil, does not fade, does not change, does not decay, it does not go away. The heaven is going to be heaven, and it is going to be awesome. Amen? It's going to be amazing. Heaven is going to be wonderful. And God has got that for us. He's keeping it for us. And he's keeping it for us. And that salvation that we have, he's protecting us so that we can get to heaven. Anybody, y'all think about heaven? Think how great it's going to be? I think about it all the time. I mean, just one of those things that puts a smile on your face. And I was just kind of working back and forth through this week. Why is heaven going to be so amazing? Besides the fact that it's heaven. And the first thing that I thought of was new bodies. 1 Corinthians 15, new bodies. Anybody got any aches and pains?
Don't we all?
Yeah. Maybe got a little bit of arthritis going on, some aches and some pains. Maybe eyes don't work as good as they used to, hear as good as they used to. Joints don't move as good as they used to. Maybe not as strong as you once be. Yeah. Amen. Well, we ought to all give some amen on that this morning, because I think we pretty much describe everybody at some point, one way or another, right? We all have some kind of difficulty going on with these old earthly bodies that we have. And that's the way God designed them, because now we got something to look forward to. The more we ache, the more we in pain, the more things that we go through, the more we look forward to getting that new body in heaven. And it's going to be an awesome body, and it's going to be a perfect. Can you imagine waking up with no nothing? That when you're a kid, come on now, we all remember back when we were kids. When you're a kid, you jump out of bed, hit the floor, and you're gone, right? And as you age, you wake up and you lay there for a minute, and then you decide to raise up and sit there for a minute, and then you slowly turn, put your feet on the floor, and then you kind of easily stand up, put some weight on those old feet and knees, and then you kind of bend over, and then you kind of slowly start to stretch back up and get up right. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about. Some of y'all are older than I am, and you know what I'm talking about in here, because I'm already to that point. Amen?
That's when you start leaning on God more.
That's when you start leaning on God more. The thing about it is, these old bodies break down, and that's something that they age for. And that's okay, folks, because it helps us look forward to get to heaven. It helps us look forward into that new body. It helps us when we're sitting there going, oh my gosh, I don't know how I'm going to make it through today. My knees are killing me. It helps us to look forward and understand that once God calls us home, that once God gets us there, that all that's going to be no more. Amen? Y'all get tired? Get a little sick every now and then? A little weak feeling every now and then? When we get to heaven, that's no more. When we get that new body, that's no more. We don't have to worry about any of that stuff. We've been studying Revelation on Wednesday night. We ain't quite got to this part, but we're about to get there. Jesus said, or God says, that he's taking all that away. There's not going to be any more pain, no more sorrow, no more sickness, no more tears, or anything. He's taking all that old stuff away, and everything is becoming new. You get new bodies. We get new bodies, ain't you? I was, thank God, I was watching a comedian some time ago. He was telling the story that he went to visit one of his friends and get to his friend's house, and he did like a body cast from his waist, from his neck down to his waist, and he's like, man, what happened? Fall down a flight of stairs or get in an accident or, you know, something. He goes, no, he goes, man, then come John snuck up on me too fast and it went out and I just broke all this loose on both sides. We don't have to worry about that, amen, because God is going to give us a perfect, flawless, untired, unsick, healthy body that we can praise him and that we can worship him again. Amen. If our worship is good now, and what we're working with, imagine what our worship is going to be when we get to heaven. Cartwheels, backflips, yeah, we're going to be doing all that kind of stuff because it's going to be great. I was thinking about something, you know, we're not a custom built home waiting. Y'all know how much money is still on custom built homes these days? You can't just go and, you know, some people just can't go and build a house and go, yeah, just give me something you think I would like. If they sat down with a builder and they put this here and they put that there and they make it unique to their own taste, their own family life. We got a custom built home waiting on us that is totally unique to only us. There is nobody else in heaven that Jesus is working on the home for anybody else other than us. It's going to be unique to us. Amen? Custom built. Can you imagine think about what God did in 6 days. Jesus has been working on his house for 2,000 years. Come on. Can you imagine how amazing it's going to be? Can you imagine how amazing heaven is going to be? And it's not just a home. Some of your translations, King James, are even talking about a mansion. What do you think about when you hear the word mansion?
Big luxury type home.
Can you imagine getting into heaven and Jesus, you're walking with you and he brings you up to the, I don't know if I don't have your heart or not, but as you talk about it, man, he brings you up to this is your home, your mansion, and he's working on it. He's like, man, this is all yours. And I built it for nobody else but you. And it is unique to you. It's all yours. Amen? It's going to be amazing. And even I think what's which I think is even more amazing than that, is we're going to actually get to talk to two biblical people. I just want to know the amount of fear and joy that Moses experienced when he walked through the Red Sea with water on both sides. But y'all know water's not quiet. You know what I mean? I mean, it's never quiet. There's always some sound. And when God blows that wind and blows it back, you know that he's creating pressure. And you know that he's creating some swirling. And you know that the water is clapping and swirling and making. I wonder the amount of fear, but also the amount of amazement and joy and awe and wonder that was in Moses when he experienced that. I've never experienced anything like that. Y'all? I would like to know exactly how big Goliath was and how scared was David. You know, because fear, the absence of fear is not courage. Courage is moving forward in the presence of fear. Well, David had great courage to go out. Even though he was walking in the presence of God, he had great courage to go out. You know, young David, to face a giant of a man, battle hardened. I want to know how scared was he, David. You know what I'm talking about? I want to know what it was like for Peter and Andrew and James and John when they were fishing all night. And then you come back up on the shore and Jesus is there and he says, y'all catch anything? And they're like, no. Well, put your nets on the other side. They're like, dude, we just told you we've been fishing all night and haven't caught anything. Well, because they knew Jesus was special, they drop their nets down, and as soon as they drop their nets down, it begins to fill up with so many fish that their boat starts to sink. I want to know what they were thinking in that moment. When we get to heaven, I don't know if we're going to think about this kind of question or not, but when we get to heaven, the opportunity is going to be there. You know what I mean? We're going to be able to speak with Moses and Abraham, Jacob, Isaac. We're going to be able to ask Abraham, what was going through your mind when you were leading Isaac up the mountain to sacrifice for God? All these things that we think about and we read and all these people, we're going to be able to sit there and converse with them, converse with them and ask them, what was it like?
I'd like to ask Mary that question.
What was it like, Mary? What was it like giving birth to the Son of God? You know what I'm talking about? What was it like knowing that he was special? What was it like when you knew that his death was going to save you? Anybody got anybody you want to talk to?
You want to ask Job what all he went through?
Yeah. I mean, I think we can all recall Bible stories that we think about that we're like, man, I would love to find out what these people were thinking in those moments. When we get to heaven, we're going to be able to do that. How amazing is that? And probably the greatest of all, we're going to get to see Jesus. You know what I mean? See what he actually looked like. Is Jesus tall? Did he build? Was he muscular? Did he have a long hair? Did he have a beard? Yeah. Who knows? What is? Who knows what it's like? Only the people that walk with him. I mean, we've got pictures. I've probably seen 100 different pictures of what people painted Jesus, and each one of them is different. How could one man be different that many times? You know what I mean? I'm pretty sure that when we get there, we're going to be able to see Jesus and actually put a face to the one in front of him. You know what I mean? We're actually going to be able to go up and hug him. We're actually going to be able to go up and say, thank you so much. Thank you for what you did on the cross. I would be in such deep trouble right now if it had not been for your sacrifice. If it had not been for your sacrifice, if it had not been for the faith that you gave me, Lord, I would not even be here right now. I would not even be able to accept this inheritance. I would not even be able to praise God without the faith that you have given us. We have all of that because of Jesus, and we're actually going to get to see who that Jesus is. Is it just me, or does that put a little bit of joy, a little bit of spring in our steps? Because we've already said that we've all got health problems, we've all got financial troubles, we've all got relationship troubles. The world is chewing us up and spitting us out as we know it. But it doesn't have to be that way, because we can walk with a smile on our face because we have an inheritance. Amen. We have a place that we know that we are going that is going to be incomprehensible, better than where we are right now. Incomparable, I should say. Better than where we are right now. We can't even comprehend what heaven is going to be like. I was thinking about it the other day. Streets of gold. Now, let's just figure this out. Can you imagine walking in a place that is so luxurious that the streets are actually dead? Or can you walk, can you imagine walking in a place that is so luxurious that gold is actually paved? For me, that pavement out there on the highway, we don't think much about it, just rock and gravel. Right? There's a lot of other things that we replace over that pavement, right? When we get to heaven, our pavement is even going to be better. Come on, now.
But it's not going to matter.
It's not going to matter.
We're not going to be thinking of the riches of the gold and all the beautiful gems and stuff. We're just going to be thankful that we're there with Jesus.
We're going to be thankful that we're there with Jesus. But can we picture that place and brighten our spirits today?
Oh, I can envision
it. You know, Jesus said that he came so that he may have life and have it completely. Now, I don't believe that just happened. I believe that's you. I believe that's here as well. And I believe that on those days, that when we think we can't praise God the most, those are the days that we need to be praising him. When we're in those days where we're sitting there and we're bummed out and our same old life has got us down, those are the days that we need to think of heaven. Those are the days that we need to think of the inheritance that we've got. Those are the days, think of the hope that we have. Those are the days, think that God is watching over us right now and our salvation is sealed up in him through faith in Jesus Christ. And he can't wait to show us this, amen?
When I start getting bottled down here, I just stop and think it's only temporary.
It's only temporary. I've got my trip planned. My travel arrangements are already secured, already paid for. It's all taken care of. Amen. Anybody else? Travel arrangements already made. Travel arrangements. It's all paid for. It's all done. Made by Jesus Christ, paid for by Jesus Christ, and when Jesus Christ calls us, we're going to answer that call, and we're going to take that trip, amen? Mm-hmm. And it's no longer going to be wondering what heaven is going to be like.
You don't know.
We're going to be experiencing what heaven is going to be like, amen? Mm-hmm. I don't know about the rest of you. That just does something to you. It just puts a joy in my heart, a smile on my face, a clean. That we have a Savior. That we have a God that loves us enough to believe that he comes flesh, walk the earth as a man, die so that we can have the opportunity to have that. That's right. If you have got your travel arrangements made, that's amazing. But if you haven't today, and you feel that God is talking to you, I would encourage you to make those arrangements. Because we're not guaranteed tomorrow, folks. Today could be the day that the train whistle blows. You know what I mean? Today could be the day that we get to take that trip. It's awesome for those that are prepared. Not so much for those who aren't. Anybody ever had to travel somewhere and not be prepared? Yeah. Anybody ever think that you've got everything packed and you get everything and you get to wherever you're going and you're like, I forgot this, I forgot that, I should have done this, I didn't do that. Right? Yeah. We've all been in those places, right? That's when Jesus blows that whistle. We don't want to have that going on in our lives, amen? If you're down and out today, folks, there's a big reason why today can be bad. There's also a big reason why today can be good, amen? Think about what Christ has. Think about what we're going to feel when we walk in. Open arms. Oh, come on. Not over his life. Can you feel those Jesus hugs on earth? Can you imagine what it's going to feel like to actually feel Jesus hugs in person? Smile today. What are you doing today? Sure, it may be the same old thing, but we've got something greater on the horizon. Amen? Father God, again, we thank you for this amazing day that you've blessed us with. We thank you so much, dear Lord, that this is not all we have. that we have something greater to look for. Not that we're greedy, dear God, but just sometimes this whole world gets us down, man. We just need something to pick us back up, dear God. We thank you so much for that, dear Lord. We just ask that you take us into the rest of the day and this week with joy in our hearts and smiles on our faces, dear God, as we know that you have it all waiting for us. We're going to sing a closing hymn, and we're going to open up the altar. you know, if you give your life to the Lord, that's amazing. If you haven't, you've been following the week, so let's do that today. Even if you have just something that weighed on your heart and you want to talk to him about, please come down. Don't hesitate, because